Okay, this is the practical 4. Okay, this is the last practical. Officially, this is the last session. Okay, so let's see. So this I will not ask in the exam. Okay, this is for you people to know what is keratinizing, non-keratinizing. Understand? Because I got fed up because nobody is going and studying. Okay, I mean many of them are not studying this. This is very important, brother. This is keratinizing stratified squamous epithelium. This is non-keratinizing stratified squamous epithelium. This is the layer is missing here. Understand? It is missing here. See, this is the keratinizing layer of the keratinizing stratified squamous epithelium in the skin. Understand? This layer is not in the oral mucosa. Okay? It is non-keratinizing stratified squamous epithelium. Okay? It's not in the exam. But you have to understand. So, please try to understand. This is the basal layer. This is the basal layer. If the basal cells increase, it is dysplasia. It is dysplasia. Understand? So, this also I will not keep. This slide is very important. Okay? So, they start with hyperplasia and they will go for dysplasia, then they will become cancer. Okay? So, the severe dysplasia is called carcinoma in situ. The criteria should carcinoma in situ is they should not break the basement membrane. The basement membrane should not be breached. Okay? They should not break the basement membrane. Okay, good question actually. So, if I keep this slide, okay, I will hide this one and I will ask what is the change. It is carcinoma in situ. Okay, it is carcinoma in situ. Okay, so this is the benign. Woma means benign. It is woma means benign. It contains fibro plus adeno. It is a mixed tumor of the breast. Fibroadenoma. Understand? It is mixed tumor of the breast. It is a benign tumor. If I keep this slide, I will ask what is the diagnosis. You should write fibroadenoma. Okay. Next, if this is the carcinoma of the breast, see, it is completely spreading. Okay. So, it is, if I keep, what is the diagnosis? Carcinoma of the breast. So, it is related to the polyp and colon cancer. Okay. So, if I show this one, it is the polyp. See, it is the cancer, it is going invading. See, it is invading the muscle. I mean, intestinal smooth muscle. This is the mucosa, right? This is the mucosa. See, it is ulcer and it is invading. It is cancer. Okay? It is cancer. So, if I close this one and if I ask what it is cancer. If I close this one and if I ask what it is polyp. This is just to know the difference. Okay. Now, this is the benign skeletal muscle tumor. Understand? Rhabdo means skeletal muscle, myo means muscle, woma means benign. Benign skeletal muscle tumor. Okay. If I keep this, you have to write what is the diagnosis? Rhabdomyoma. Rhabdomyoma. See, this is the malignant skeletal muscle tumor. Sarcoma means malignant cancer and it is from skeletal muscle. It is rhabdomyosarcoma. If I keep this, what is the diagnosis? It is rhabdomyosarcoma. So I will keep this slide. Okay. So this is the benign thyroid tumor, follicular adenoma. This is the cancerous thyroid tumor, follicular carcinoma. You can see the difference, right? This is well circumscribed and they have a capsule. See, it is not having any circumscription. Okay, so it is follicular carcinoma. So now let's come to this. Okay, see, this is basically for understanding. Please understand this case. Okay, so normally the case comes like this. For example, a 43 years old male having cough with expectoration, means sputum, cough with sputum, is having 20 years of smoking. So what we do is we will do bronchoscopy and we will see inside what is happening, and he is having some white lesion and ulcer. Okay, so they take a biopsy from that. And they will send to the pathology lab. Then we do staining and other stuff. This is just to show how the respiratory epithelium. Okay, I will not ask in the exam. This is how to show how the respiratory epithelium. Understand? See, this epithelium, because he is 20 years smoking, it is changed to squamous. It is metaplasia. Understand? It is metaplastic change. Then it is, see the basal cell, it is increasing here. It is mild dysplasia. Here it is increased more. It is moderate dysplasia. It is severely increased in both the case. It is severe dysplasia carcinoma in situ. Okay. So in these 5 slides, I may ask anyone. Okay. It's very, very important. So it starts with metaplasia, it goes with mild dysplasia, moderate dysplasia, severe dysplasia, okay, and end up with carcinoma in situ. See, the basement membrane is intact, no cell is coming out. So what happens here? It is completely coming out and it is spreading. Okay, it is squamous cell, invasive squamous cell carcinoma. So this invasive squamous cell carcinoma and this carcinoma in situ, you should know to tell the difference. Understand? Only the difference is basement membrane. So these two are very important. Okay. Okay, once again I'm telling. So this is rhabdo, if I ask, you should write rhabdomyosarcoma. This is rhabdomyoma. Understand? This is cancer and this is polyp. You should write it as a colonic cancer. Understand? This write as a colonic polyp. And if I keep this, you should write it as carcinoma of breast. And this is fibroadenoma. So it starts as hyperplasia, then they will become mild, moderate, severe. Severe dysplasia is called carcinoma in situ, then they will become cancer.